Hi Brolies, Marvin here from techbrawl.com, where we do unboxings, reviews, and sexy b-rolls. And today I share with you my experience upgrading my Synology NAS from Synology DS220 Plus to the top of the line in terms of their 4-bay NAS lineup, the Synology DS920 Plus. This will be a step-by-step tutorial on how to migrate the hard drives from one Synology NAS to another, as well as a walkthrough on how to set it up via the Diskstation Manager operating system. I'll also share with you some of the possible upgrade paths down the line to fully take advantage of the Synology DS920 Plus. With that being said, let's get into it. Alright guys, first things first, of course, I gotta have a reason why I need to upgrade my good working Synology DS220 Plus and why I decided to go for the Synology DS920 Plus. I'm gonna be honest, I basically have two reasons why I had to upgrade. The first reason is the obvious one. I only have two 4TB hard drives on my Synology DS220 Plus and it quickly got full and I had to constantly delete files for it to continue working, which is quite annoying. Granted, I could have just replaced the hard drives to larger ones, but then again, at some point, it will start to get full again, especially that I store huge video RAW files. And I'm also thinking about the future, wherein I can potentially use a NAS other than for backing up my files. Maybe I can set up a media server, video surveillance, and other things that you can take advantage of from a Synology NAS. The second reason is that, again, to be honest, I reached out to Synology and Synology actually agreed to provide the Synology DS920 Plus, so I figured why not, and this is a perfect opportunity not only to be able to upgrade my NAS but to experience their top-of-the-line offering. So with a little bit of background out of the way, let's start the migration process. Let's start with the unboxing of the Synology DS920 Plus. The packaging is the typical brown box I've grown familiar with when it comes to Synology NAS, and around the box we just have some branding, some of its key features, specifications, and package contents. Upon opening the box, we have a couple of accessory boxes and the Synology DS920 Plus nicely protected by cardboard box and styrofoam. Like I said, we have a couple of accessory boxes right here. Inside the smaller one, we have the power cable, and inside the larger accessory box, we have the rest of the package contents. We have the power brick, two Ethernet cables, a set of mounting screws, a couple of plastic keys, and of course, a quick installation guide with easy-to-understand illustrations and instructions. Finally, we have the Synology DS920 Plus right here, protected by a thin styrofoam-like cover. At first look and touch, the design and construction feels quite similar to its smaller brother, the one that I'm currently using, the Synology DS220 Plus. On both sides, we have a Synology logo that also doubles as a subtle ventilation. And then flipping it on the front side, we have our hard drive slots, and as you can tell, we have a total of 4 drive bays. And as I pointed out earlier, this is their top-of-the-line offering when it comes to their 4-bay lineup. So we have key slots for each drive bay, and then right here we have 5 LED indicators, 4 for the hard drives and 1 for the overall status of the Synology NAS. We also have a USB 3.0 port here, and a power button with an LED indicator. Flipping it all over at the other side, we have two 92mm exhaust fans, a Kensington lock slot, another USB 3.0 port, two 1GB Ethernet ports, an eSATA port, and the power port. Unfortunately, we don't have any USB Type-C port with this one. Overall, in terms of the design, it is pretty straightforward, nothing fancy and should fit any environment. As for the construction, although made mostly out of hard plastic materials, for the external closure, it is solid enough and once hard drives are installed, it won't move at all. Now, in terms of possible upgrades for the hardware side of things, you can actually install two M.2 NVMe SSDs here to further improve the performance by introducing SSD caching. And you can also upgrade the memory to 8GB by adding 4GB of RAM. More on that later though. Now, like I said, we have a couple of plastic keys and a locking mechanism for each drive bay to protect your data from theft or unauthorized access. Removing the drive bays is super easy, all you have to do is lift up the lever like so and just simply pull out the drive bay as you can see here. The drive bays are also made out of hard plastic materials, so be a bit careful when handling them. Once the drive bay has been removed, we now have a visual of the tiny motherboard inside with SATA connectors and whatnot. And looking towards the right side, we have the additional memory slot for a possible upgrade if necessary. Now, looking closer on the drive bay, it has a locking mechanism that snaps the lever shut in a very satisfying manner. And then we have a couple of locking mechanisms as well for securing the hard drive without having to use any kind of tools, which is pretty awesome. All you have to do is pull it away like so, and it should snap out of the drive bay quite easily. Now, for the additional hard drive, since we're now upgrading from a 2-bay NAS to a 4-bay NAS, we need another couple of NAS drives. And what I have here for the sake of compatibility are another two 4TB Toshiba N300 NAS drives, since I'm using the same on my Synology DS220 Plus. This should make our migration a lot easier. Installing the hard drive is equally easy. All you have to do is slide the drive in the correct orientation, of course, with the SATA connector facing outwards. Snap the two locking covers like so. And if you want an extra layer of protection, you can also secure the hard drive with a screw. But as per my experience, this isn't really necessary, especially if you don't move the NAS around. After that, all you have to do is slide the drives back in the correct orientation with the SATA connectors facing down. Lock it in place, secure it with the key if necessary, and you're good to go. Now, all that is left is to plug in the Ethernet cable, connect it with the router, plug in the power adapter, turn on the NAS, and head into your computer to start the setup process. However, for this video, we're not just straight setting up the Synology DS920 Plus, but instead, we're going to migrate my hard drives from the Synology DS220 Plus to the Synology 920 Plus as part of the overall upgrade. If you want to learn how to set up a NAS the regular way, you can watch either of my two videos that I've already done, one for the Synology DS220 Plus and another one for the Synology DS220J. I'll put the links below so that you can check it out. Now, before we start, I'd like to share that I found two useful guides on how to properly migrate a Synology NAS to another Synology NAS. The first one is from Synology itself, which is quite extensive and has a lot of valuable information, especially for compatibility, prerequisites, and pretty much everything you need to know to do this process. However, I also found another guide, which is a much simpler guide and a very easy to understand guide that is from Lester Chan of lesterchan.net. So full credits go to him, and I link the full tutorial below so that you can check it out. However, I didn't follow everything because some of the details on his guide didn't apply to my personal setup. So yeah, but I'd say his guide really made the process a lot easier. Full disclaimer though, that I still do recommend you to check out the guide from Synology to make sure you back up and take everything into consideration. Alright, so to start, of course, we have to transfer the two hard drives from the Synology DS220 Plus to the Synology DS920 Plus, and you have to do it in the proper order to make sure everything will work fine later when we finally set this up on a web browser. Doing this is pretty simple. Just get the first drive bay from the Synology DS220 Plus, and the locking mechanism is actually just the same. Then insert it on the first bay of the Synology DS920 Plus. Then the second one from the DS220 Plus into the second slot of the DS920 Plus. After that, if you want to add more hard drives like what I have here, just install them on the third and fourth slot. And that's it, pretty straightforward, right? Now again, plug the cables in, power on the NAS, and wait for it to boot, indicated by a loud beep, and head into your computer and open a new browser. Again, before proceeding on following this guide, make sure to check the official Synology guide, at least for the requirements, compatibility, and the right migration method for your particular setup and needs. I should not be responsible for any data loss, and this video should only serve as a reference. And again, what I followed is the guide by Lester Chan, and I did almost exactly what he did, and it worked out for me without any issues. With that being said, I still followed some of the steps mentioned on the official guide, like backing up my shared folders, packages, and system configurations. Although I didn't have to restore them after the migration, since after the process, everything seems to be working fine, so yeah. Now, before I started the migration process, I made sure my DSM or Diskstation manager is up to date. Alright, so to start the migration process, open a web browser and go to find.synology.com. Make sure the Synology DS920 Plus and your computer is connected to the same network. It should be able to detect the Synology 920 Plus, as you can see here, with a migratable status. Click connect, then next, and as you can see, the setup was able to detect properly that I've moved my hard drives from DS220 Plus to the DS920 Plus, and that we can migrate both our data and settings to the Synology DS920 Plus. So ideally, it should work pretty straightforward. Click Migrate, and in here, you have two options. The first one is Migration, which essentially will just migrate your files and settings as well as the current state of your DSM. The other option is a complete reinstallation of Synology NAS while still retaining your data. This will basically reinstall the DSM operating system, and of course with that, you'll have to reconfigure everything again. For my personal needs, since I don't really have much packages installed and configurations to take in mind that might get lost, I decided to just straight migrate everything. And even if some packages or configurations get lost in the process, like I mentioned earlier, I did a backup of those files, so I shouldn't really worry at all. Now, after the installation, I was able to log in straight using my old credentials, which is pretty awesome. And now we are inside the DSM or the Diskstation Manager operating system. As you can tell, our storage information still says it's full, and that is because we haven't set up the additional hard drives yet, so that's our next step. So what I did here is I went to Storage Manager, then Storage Pool, then Action, and Add Drive. Do note that what I have here is SHR, or the most basic configuration, with one drive redundancy. Choose both 3rd and 4th drive if you have additional drives like me, and click Next. It says here that the Toshiba N300 NAS drives that I have here aren't listed on the compatibility list yet, but I can tell you right now that I have been using the DS920 Plus for a month now, and I haven't encountered any issues yet. So click Continue and make sure the hard drives that you added are either new or don't contain any important data. Click OK and click Apply. After that, the system will conduct a party test while it is expanding to make sure everything is okay. Now, I noticed here that for some reason, my 4th drive stayed in initialized status and verified that it wasn't included in the expansion process. So what I did is I just waited for the current expansion process to finish, and then after that, I added the 4th drive to the pool and again waited for the party check to finish. Your mileage may vary, of course, and that's pretty much it. The overall migration process can take less than 30 minutes, except for the parity check, which can take hours to finish. After that, I checked my shared folders, packages, and configurations, and everything seems to be present and working properly, especially my backup settings. So yeah, I didn't really have to restore anything else after the migration process, and now I have a fully working Synology DS920 Plus with a lot more storage space to work with. And in the future, I can even expand this up to 9 drives using the DX517 expansion unit. So right now, I'm just using the Synology DS920 Plus as a backup storage for all my important files, which to be honest is a bit overkill, especially for its specifications and other things it can do other than backing up my files. Not to mention it's quite hefty price. So in the future, I'm planning on using this for other things, such as media server, probably for when I set up a proper video surveillance system here in our home, as a web server if I want to develop a website locally, as a virtual machine if I want to explore different operating systems, applications, and things around that nature. And the use case scenarios are actually the sky's the limit with the Synology DS920 Plus, especially that you can even upgrade its RAM and add a couple of M.2 NVMe SSD cache to improve its performance should the necessity arise, like for example, if I will use this for multiple applications at the same time. So yeah, if that ever happens, I'll probably make another video about it. But for now, I'll just enjoy having peace of mind knowing that I have a proper backup system and that I have tons of storage space to work with. And there you have it guys, thank you for watching. If you need help on setting up your NAS, especially for the Synology DS220 Plus and DS220J, make sure to check my setup guide videos linked below. Huge thanks of course to Synology for sending this in, you can get this from the link below as well. Again, thank you for watching, subscribe if you like this, and see you next time. Have a great day guys, you're awesome.